हेलो चिल्ड्रेन, वेलकम बैक. वंस अगेन वी हैव टू डू एन एक्टिविटी टुडे एंड टुडे आवर एक्टिविटी इज आर्ट इंटीग्रेटेड एक्टिविटी रिलेटेड टू फ्रैक्शंस. नाउ चिल्ड्रेन, टुडे वी विल लर्न हाउ वी कैन ड्रॉ डिफरेंट शेप्स एंड सम ब्यूटिफुल पिक्चर्स यूजिंग द फ्रैक्शंस. नाउ यू मस्ट बी थिंकिंग दैट वेयर आर द फ्रैक्शंस. यस, दीज आर द फ्रैक्शंस. सो very first, if I give you a brief introduction of this fractions, so what shape you are looking here, you will say that it is a circle, ma'am. But no, actually in terms of fraction, this complete figure is called a whole. What it is called? It is called a whole. Okay children, now here as you can see that I have taken three different colors, circular whole fractions. Along with that, we are going to use a pencil, an eraser, a scissors and some glue to paste the pictures. Now very first, starting with the first one, and this first whole I am going to divide this into two halves. So taking this two halves, that means I have to fold it into two equal parts. So this is how I have folded, right? So now you can see that there is a line here in between which divides this complete whole into two equal halves. Right children, let us cut this into two equal halves now. Okay, so these are the two halves. Since it is half, so it is 1/2 and 1/2. Okay, this is our first part. Now coming to the second one, taking the second whole part, and this part of the circular sheet I am going to divide it into four equal parts. How many parts? Four equal parts. See, it is done. Four equal parts, half and one more half. So hence it is divided into four equal parts. Now let us cut it using the scissors. So as you can see that I have cut it down them into the four equal parts. Now what fraction should I write for each of these? Yes, it, since I have divided one whole into four equal parts, so it is 1/4, 1/4, 1/4 and 1/4. So this is the second part of our fraction, which is 1/4. Okay children, 1/2, 1/4. Now the third disc is also there, and this disc I am going to divide into eight equal parts. So for eight equal parts, very first this is half, then one more fold, so this is 1/4. And if I make one more fold here, so now it will become 1/8. Let's check out. Is it 1/8? Yes. See how many parts are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now it's time to cut it using the scissors. Now cutting down like this. Please children, be very careful while cutting these discs. Whenever you use scissors or any sharp thing, please be very careful and do it in the guidance of your parents. Okay. One last. Okay. Now children, as you can see that I have cut it down all the parts into eight equal portions. Now what fraction I will write here? 1/8, 1/8, 1/8. Just because this whole is divided into eight equal parts, so it is 1/8. So now you can see that we have divided one of the circular disc into halves, another one into 1/4, and the last one into 1/8. Now we are going to make some very interesting pictures which is actually a part of art integration using these fractions. So now I will be keeping them on one side, and let me tell you how you can use these pictures. Very first, to draw a beautiful flower, I will be using a half. So here is the fraction of half. So let me apply some glue on this. So children, now let's paste this part. So pasting this here, see, this is a half part of a fraction. Now for the rest part, I will be using two portions of 1/4, and now I will paste them like this. So children, can you just see, we got a flower bud here. Yes, this is such a beautiful flower bud made from fractions. So see, maths is so beautiful that we can draw and we can make anything using the mathematics terms, and the different concepts of maths can be applied in any form, even in our art also. So here I have pasted one of the 1/4, and now I am going to paste the another part. So our flower bud is done, but this is looking something incomplete. So let's complete this flower bud. So for that, I am going to give it a finishing touch. So here is the stem with a beautiful leaf on one side. So children, can you just see that we have drawn a beautiful flower bud using the fractions. So children, after completing this flower bud, I am going to give it the name. This is a flower bud. Now, since here in this flower bud we have used a half and 1/4, now we are going to use the 1/8 also. Okay, so using the rest of the pictures, I am going to tell you that how we can make a beautiful bird using the concept of fractions. So very first, I will be using this half part, and this half fraction will represent the body of the bird, or you can say the trunk part. Now coming to the head part. So for making the head part, I am going to use the fraction 1/4, and we will paste it like this. Okay children, see, 1/4. Then is the head part, or you can say the beak of the bird. So that beak I am going to represent using this 1/8 part, and let's paste it like this. Right children? Okay, now what is the next part of a bird? The next part is its tail part. So using the fractions of 1/8, I am going to prepare its tail. So let us make the tail now. So very first, 1/8, then a fraction 1/4, like this. After that, I'm going to use one more fraction of 1/8 to complete the tail of our bird, like this. Now let us put some more portions here, and like this. Now one small portion of 1 upon 8 is left and I am going to make the side feather of the bird using this 1/8 like this. Right, children? So here you can see that our art integrated bird using the fraction is ready. Now what we have to do? We have to give it a finishing touch. So let us give the finishing touch by drawing the legs of the bird. Right, children? Okay. At the same time, I am also going to draw the eyes of the bird. Okay. Then let us give some more colors to its feathers like this. Right, children? So as you can see, our bird is ready using the fractions. So let us give it the name bird. Okay, children? So children, today we have drawn two different art integrated pictures using the concept of fractions. In the similar manner, children, you also have to prepare at least one picture using the fractions, the concept of fractions, and send it to me as soon as possible. Thank you for the lesson, students. Have a great day.